Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar.
Ali ibn Ibrahim has narrated from his father, from Hammād ibn Isā, who said the following. Abu Abdullah al-Sadeq alayhi salam one day asked me, "Do you know how to perform salat properly?" I said, "I have the book of salat from Hurayz." The Imam said, "Never mind, O Hammād. Stand up and perform salat." Hammād said, "I then stood up in his presence, facing the direction of Qibla. I began performing salat with ruku' and sujood." He then said, "O Hammād, you do not know how to pray properly. How ugly is it for a man of your people who at the age of 60 or 70 cannot even perform one prayer according to its complete rules and manners?" Hammād said, "I felt incredible shame within me." I then asked him, saying, "May I be sacrificed for you? Teach me how to pray properly." Abu Abdullah al-Sadiq alayhi salam then stood up straight, facing the direction of Qibla. He allowed his hands to rest on his thighs, with his fingers held together, and kept his feet near each other, only leaving between them a distance of 3 fingers opened up. With his toes facing the direction of Qibla, without letting them deviate from its direction, he then said with humbleness, "Allahu Akbar." He then recited Alhamd with clarity and fluency, followed by "Qul Huwallahu Ahad." He then paused for a breath while still standing and raised his hands up to the sides of his face and said, "Allahu Akbar." He then knelt down for ruku'. He placed his palms over his knees, allowing them to be filled up with his knees, while his fingers were separate from each other. He pressed back against his knees until his back became so straight that if there'd been a drop of water or oil on it, it would not move due to it being so level. He stretched his neck forward, closed his eyes, and then said with clarity and fluency 3 times, "Subhana Rabbi al-Azim wa bihamdi." He then stood up straight. When he settled, he said, "Sami'a Allahu liman hamida." While still standing, he raised his hands up to the sides of his face and said, "Allahu Akbar." Then he bowed down for prostration. He placed his palms with his fingers close side by side, aligned them with his knees beside his face, and said 3 times, "Subhana Rabbi al-A'la wa bihamdi." He did not place any other part of his body on any other part thereof. He prostrated on 8 bones, his palms, knees, the tips of his toes, his forehead, and his nose. The Imam then said, 7 of these is an obligation, while the nose is a sunnah. He then raised his head from sujood. When he sat up straight, he said, "Allahu Akbar." He then sat on his left thigh, placing the back of his right foot over the sole of his left foot, and then said, "Astaghfirullah Rabbi wa atubu ilayh." He then said, "Allahu Akbar." Then bowed down for a second sajda, saying what he said in the first. He did not place any other part of his body on any other part during ruku' or sujood. He spread his elbows like wings and did not place his arms on the ground. And just like that, he performed 2 units of prayer. The Imam then kept the fingers of his hands close side by side when saying the tashahud, that is, the testimonies of faith whilst seated. When he finished saying the testimonies, he then said salam and told me, O Hammād, you must perform salat like this.
أشهد أن